Hello everybody and welcome to another evening of Nail Talk Live. And no, it's not just the two of us tonight. We are with all of us together and we have a special guest.
Yeah, we have a special guest, this blush babe, and we're really going to need her tonight, so...
Yeah, you already mentioned blush babe, mm-hmm. because today we are launching worldwide the Blushes by Magnetic. And these blushes, what are they?
Yeah, well, it's a gel, it's something
It's a builder in a bottle.
Yeah.
It's magic.
Yeah, it's magic. It's absolutely magic.
It's a trend.
It's a trend as well. And it's not alone blushes.
Mm-hmm.
It needs something besides it.
Yeah, it's blushes and a treatment.
Yeah.
The blush treatment.
Yes.
For the blush treatment, we need the blushes and we need our blush babe. And our blush babe is Silvana. We have a lot of demos as well for you from our international trainers. And it all boils down to the perfect natural nail treatment. So, anxious? Let's get started. So welcome, Silvana, our blush babe.
Hello, everybody. I'm so excited to be here tonight.
Yeah, blushes are like the perfect makeup, but then for natural nails. Eh?
Yeah, perfect makeup for natural nails.
We even mentioned it in the beginning. It's like foundation. It suits your skin.
Yeah.
So what is the blushes?
The blushes are, oh my God, amazing product. Our builder gels in a bottle, as you mentioned, four on the natural nails in 12 different colors for each skin type.
Yeah, builders in the bottle. And it is, so how did it go? 1.5 years ago, you came to us as a model, mm-hmm. from Syriza, because yeah. you always take Silvana with you.
Yeah, all the time. She's a great model as well, so.
Yeah, so I've known Silvana now for, I think, almost 3 years.
Yeah,
I think so.
And she started as a very quiet girl.
Mm-hmm.
But at a certain moment, about 1.5 years ago, we were in the midst of the first corona lockdown.
Yeah.
And we were filming demos yeah. because of Nail Talk Live.
Yeah.
And here in the studio, it's corona proof, mm-hmm. because we're only the four of us.
Yeah.
And we just launched Rubber Base.
Yeah. Yeah, so this is an extended one. And there enters Silvana.
Yeah, because you then came to talk to me about the rubber bases. And what did you tell me?
Yeah, I saw a trend on Instagram going on about like shades, nude shades for natural nails. So for reinforcing on the natural nails.
Yeah,
that's
reinforcing
what I saw.
The natural nails.
Yeah.
But very short.
Yeah, very short.
Very short, very natural, and also very young.
Yeah, young people, influencers, young girls in my salon came to me and be like, oh, I want nude nails. I don't want red nails or purple or, yeah, a little bit pink, but just girly and nude.
So for our information, let's show you guys at home. This is a blush treatment. Perfect natural nails, very thin,
yeah.
very short. Well, these are a little bit longer.
A little bit longer, yeah.
Yeah.
And what you also see is that they are perfectly manicured.
Yeah.
Because it goes hand in hand. Eh?
Yeah, yeah, that's the whole concept. Yeah.
So tell us a little bit about concept.
Yeah, the concept is, so 50% is Russian manicure, and I prefer my combi manicure. And the other 50% is like reinforcing of the natural nail.
So you say Russian manicure. Listen, I'm already for 22 years in this profession. What is a Russian manicure?
That's the thing.
Yeah. yeah. What is it?
It's like cutting away the dead skin around the cuticle. So only the dead skin.
And that's quite a controversial thing in some countries.
Yeah, that's true. Because some people, they think that they are going to cut the living tissue.
Mm.
Yeah, and of course, we don't cut the living tissue because otherwise it's going to hurt, it's going to bleed. So that is not the point of this treatment.
And it's called a Russian manicure
yeah.
because it originates from Russia?
Yeah, that's true. They do that a whole lifetime. Or when they were young, they are used to cut away the dead skin.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, you really need to know how you cut the dead skin. But if you know your stuff, yeah, your theory, you can, of course, you can cut it and polish it and in all the right directions, of course.
Yeah.
But that's you can learn.
Yeah, so it's important to note that it's an extended manicuring surface,
yeah,
including removal of the cuticle from mm-hmm. the nail plate, and then also the dead skin cells from the proximal nail fold.
Yeah.
Just cleaning it up.
Yeah, and polishing it so it will glow, oh, very pretty.
And no blood.
No blood. No.
So this combi manicure, and you call it a combi manicure, yeah, because you combine techniques.
Yeah, I combine my manicure bits, so my bits.
For the electric file.
Yeah, and I use my scissors as a tool, but you can also use nippers if you want.
Yeah, so it's a combination yeah. of a tool and a bit.
Yeah.
This is not something that we're going to show you tonight mm-hmm. because we are firm believers of the fact that you have to go to classes.
Yeah.
Get education before you start to work on the dead skin cells of the proximal nail fold.
Yeah, of course, because we have all kind of skin types and you can learn about that different skin types in a class.
Yeah, and of course there are also contraindications.
Contraindications.
When it's not wise to cut the skin.
Yeah. And that's also very important to know.
Yeah, so we're not going to focus on the combi manicure again because you need to follow education from a certified trainer that knows how to do a combi manicure. And of course, you can visit all of our magnetic trainers and international trainers and the national trainers to get class information regarding the combi manicure class.
Yeah.
But this is 50% of the surface.
Yeah.
And then the other 50% is the reinforcement of the natural nail done with the blushes.
Done with the blushes, of course.
So it's really back to the natural nail.
Yeah, it's really natural, short and glowy and nude. So pretty for all the girls and but also older women.
Yeah, it's multi-generational. And we'll go into that a little bit later. You're going to do a live demo, of course, for us tonight.
Mm-hmm.
Just in applying the blushes on a natural nail.
Yeah, because when you see this application, it's almost magic. Because I try a lot of different gels. But
we tested a lot,
of course. And you want to know exactly what you need. She knows what she needs. But this one, this is just perfect. It's so easy.
Yeah, we took over a year to test, develop.
Yeah.
Not only the packaging, but mostly the content of the bottle, the blush itself, the mixture, the composition of the product.
But colors.
We'll go into that a little bit later. So I mentioned already before, so it's multi-generational. Mm-hmm. However, you saw a trend with young people.
Yeah, with young people, but mostly of my clients are young people. Influencers, popular on Instagram, making pictures, and they'd be like, I want nails that match perfectly on everything that I wear.
Yeah, it needs to be neutral, but groomed to perfection.
Yeah, it's so perfect.
We have here a slide of the new generation of clients, and we have here Elisa, and she's like the prototype of this new next generation girl, a little bit like you.
Yeah.
So she loves sushi, she loves brands, she's really fit, she lives the Insta life.
Mm-hmm.
And on the right hand we have Daniel, and he's really the non-specific gender, so a man who is not afraid to have his nails treated with the blushes as well.
Yeah, it's gender neutral.
Gender neutral.
Also guys want it, but very neutral, like on their own skin type.
Yeah, skin tone.
Skin tone. Yeah.
And also, of course, together with that combi manicure, because especially on men's nails, that really makes a big difference. Eh?
Yeah, it's a little bit harder because the proximal nail fold from a guy, for a man, it's not similar to the proximal nail fold of a lady, of women. But yeah, of course, you can do that, of course, but you have to go to class to learn
Also to do that.
To recognize what you work with.
To make the difference. The blush treatment goes in phases.
Yeah, three phases.
So you developed also those phases.
Mm-hmm.
So let's get back to the whole story. We first talked about this new group mm-hmm. of clients. And then we also talked about, okay, what kind of product do they need? Mm-hmm. And simultaneously, you decided to stop offering power gel surfaces gel surfaces
mm-hmm.
and to focus on that natural nail together with the three-phase system.
Yeah, three-phase system.
So how did that go?
Well, because I saw people came to me first and they'd be like, I have very short and round nails, so that's phase one. They came to me and in phase one, I only reinforced the natural nails, so no extensions.
Yeah, so it's a natural nail. So I come in as a client, it's my natural nails, but I get the Russian manicure.
Yeah, of course.
The Russian manicure and then the blush treatment.
Yeah.
So I'm not correcting the shape yet, it's just my natural nail.
Yeah.
That's a relatively easy surface.
Well, especially the first surface, it's very easy. But in that surface, it's the difficulty is to make to looking for the best color to
match choosing the perfect match.
Yeah. Yeah, to match the skin. I think that's the difficulty in the first.
And of course, the combi manicure.
Yeah, of course, because
it's going
first
to be
time.
The first time that client
experiences
the combi manicure. And in your experience, the more often a client gets a combi manicure or a Russian manicure, the easier it becomes.
Yeah, because the skin is getting used to it or something, and there's not always that hard, that piece of skin on the folds, on the proximal fold.
Yeah.
So the skin the skin gets healthier.
Yeah, it gets conditioned.
Yeah, conditioned.
In a sense.
Yeah, and then the second time, it's a little bit more easy. And easy and easy.
And each 3 weeks, you have less cleaning to do because you do it every 3 weeks.
Yeah,
three or
the
four
faces
weeks.
Go every 3 weeks.
Yeah.
So we now arrive at phase two.
Yeah, phase two.
And we see here that the nails have changed a little bit. Of course, they have grown out.
Mm-hmm.
So you rebalance them.
Yeah.
You do a fill. But what else?
I will correct the shape. So I will file it back short again.
Yeah.
So I will get the perfect shape. Like square, because most of the girls want square nails with me, and the first time they came, they already have round nails, and they in phase two I go to square.
Yeah, so the modern shape for the young generation is the square, but you could also choose to stay on the oval side for
possible.
A somewhat mature lady.
Yeah, it's possible.
Also, men prefer to have a rounder shape, not square.
No, not square. No.
So find out in your country and your region what this new type of client prefers in look and feel.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because the young girls, they want to have them square.
Yeah, but I think that may be also regionally determined.
I have them square as well. So it's possible, but you can see that the young girls, they like it more. And if you make it round, some more mature ladies, they say, oh, well, this is what I like.
Yeah, so it's interesting way to look at your markets.
Yeah.
Sure. So after the second phase, we are again 3 weeks later, and we arrive at the final phase, which then will be repeated.
Yeah. Because we have a perfect shape and now a perfect length. So we can go to the length that she wants, but obviously short.
Mm-hmm.
I go no longer than like a power gel nail or an acrylic nail. But we can stay at that length.
Mm-hmm.
And then I can do a thin fringe because we have the perfect shape and the perfect length.
And this is then what we maintain every 3 weeks again. Bring it back to the same length.
Yeah.
Redetermine the shape
and
continue wearing this.
Yeah. Yeah.
And in that phase, the client is very happy with their nails. Maybe this is that phase that they say, okay, now it's completely perfect.
Do you think it psychologically helps that the client also sees her natural nails growing to the perfection she wants to achieve?
Yeah, that's true. But
take
you have
more pride in it.
Yeah, that's true. That's true because they say, "Oh, it's much better now. Oh, it's even more better right now because the nails it's in perfect the nail is in perfect condition
and the skin is in perfect
condition.
And the
skin is also in perfect condition.
So, if somebody experiences this, are they then, let's say, hooked for life?
Oh yeah, they'd be like, "Oh, now it's so perfect. I love it." And they go to all their friends and they'd be like, "Oh, you have the perfect." Natural nails, because they are natural.
Yeah.
This is also a relatively expensive treatment here in Holland. But of course, that's very country specific.
That's true. Yeah.
So you just have to look in your own countries what works. Mm-hmm. So the natural nail needs its perfect product. And that perfect product, we developed the blushes. well. We see the whole target audience in this commercial. We see guys, we see girls, and we see different skin colors,
yeah,
of course.
Yeah, different skin colors, yeah, for each one.
And you did all those nails.
And I did all those nails,
yes. That was quite a lot of fun.
Oh, it was so fun, and all the girls were so nice.
But it also proves that we really need to have all the different colors, eh?
Yeah, I think so. Take them all, buy them all, because you're really going to need them. And if you start with a few, I think in very short time, you have to buy new ones, yeah. Because there's a lot.
Yeah, the cool thing is also the names of the blushes, because they really give an attitude to the person that wears it. But you can show that at a table.
Yeah.
So let's go to a slide going into the blushes itself.
Yes, we have 12 different builders in a bottle, so 12 different colors. Oh, so pretty, so different. We have darker shades, more warm shades, and lighter and cooler shades.
Yeah, even a white color, because that's super spot on trend.
Yeah, white color. My clients came to me and they'd be like, oh, I want milky nails, I want white, cloudy nails. Oh. Yeah,
the coverage thing was a thing.
Oh, the coverage, that's the best thing, because we were looking for the perfect coverage. We tried 75, and that was the last that we tried.
Yeah.
But then we had the 60% coverage, and that was perfect.
Yeah, yeah, because we want to have translucency at the cuticle,
but
covering at the free edge, of course.
Yeah. And that's so difficult. Oh my God.
Yeah. But we have a lot of different formulas to work on and to find the perfect product. So, of course, the product is made in the Netherlands. And why is this important? Not only because it also implies that it really conforms to all of the EU regulations for cosmetics, it also means that as we follow these rules, we also choose the correct base ingredients.
Yeah.
Like we've chosen not to add methacrylic acid, which some companies use to promote adhesion.
Yeah.
But it's also a risk when you use methacrylic acid.
Well, okay, adhesion, that's okay. But then you also can get really allergic reactions from that. If you touch the skin. So I think it's very good that it's not inside of the blushes.
But it does mean that you need a special bond.
The bonds.
Silvana will show that
That's
at her
true.
Table. It's also, of course, these young girls, they really need products that are
cruelty-free and vegan. The generation really needs that vegan and cruelty-free product.
Yeah, so cruelty-free, it's not tested on animals.
Yeah, no. That's so good.
And vegan, because it does not contain animal ingredients, animal-based ingredients.
Mm-hmm.
That's the correct way of wording it. Then a lot of people wonder, how many treatments do you do with one bottle?
Yeah, with one bottle you can do 30 treatments because you can put it in a really thin layer.
Yeah, you don't need a lot of product. It only needs to reinforce the natural layer.
Yeah, that's true. Of course, you can count it off when you're using it. But it's also, you have to look at the length of the nails that you make the most.
Yeah.
So 30,
It's very comfortable and light in wear, so it's not. It doesn't feel like there's something on your nail.
No,
it feels like a full polish.
It feels like a feather.
Yeah, but it's very, very, very rock hard, strong.
Yeah,
it's so strong.
It's the perfect combination between strength and flexibility.
Yeah, true.
The flexibility you need for it to adhere to the natural nail, the strength you need to really, strengthen the natural nail, and it really enhances also the natural nail.
Yeah.
And also the C curve of the natural nail.
Yeah, it creates a very pretty C curve that all the girls, all the people want.
Yeah.
And that's because, of course, all gels, so also these blushes, they shrink just a little bit, about 10% when they cure.
Yeah.
And that 10% just gives a little,
little
hint
pinch.
Of pressure to the C curve. Yeah. Unlike other products that can have 20% shrinkage, which really hurt.
Yeah, true.
And that
can
lead to onycholysis.
Oh, terrible.
So you will always need to balance, but we found the perfect formulation for our blushes.
Yeah, because you can make it so thin and
so thin.
Such small, such sharp corners, and it still stays on.
Yeah.
Very sharp and very edgy.
You can explain that a little bit, of course, at the table.
Yes, please.
And then you can also show us the beautiful bottles, because these bottles are also utter perfection. Just have a look.
What a great commercial. Oh my God. Silvana is going to show you more in a bit, but now I'm here for the socials. I was looking for some nice pictures. This is the first one from Henriette. It's very important that you can really display your colors, especially when you have all 12 of them, because they're really amazing. As well, this one is very, I want to show them all. So all 12 right in this picture. Very nice to make the pictures and show it on your Instagram or Facebook. And this one, the third one from Magnetic Nails and Stuff, that's Jeanette. And she made this beautiful set in the training with the color Lovely. And one for myself, don't forget about the props, because this prop, I think it's very nice. I don't know if you can see them, if you can see it real good, but there it says Blush Babe on a ribbon. Very nice, right? We also have Silvana right now on the tech table, and she's going to show you the bottles and the product as well. Right, Silvana?
Yeah, I already did this, all the colors on ColourPop. So I will show you again. See how very pretty the colors are. Such different shades, different colors.
Yeah, really 12 amazing shades.
Yeah, they absolutely.
Yeah. We are also joined now by Deborah and Jessica. Hi, also guys. In love, of course, with the black.
Of course.
Absolutely. We're back.
And I want to show you the bottles, so let's have a look. Here we have Attitude. And you see it's a mud sleeve and a wood, this wood thing. Oh, wow.
Cap.
Cap. Thank you.
A wood look.
Huh? Wood look.
Wood look cap.
Very natural.
So you're going to use Attitude?
No, I'm going to use Lovely because her skin tone is a little bit lighter, so I choose for Lovely.
Okay, that's a beautiful shade. What is your favorite color?
Well, you wouldn't say because these colors are all for next to the colors of your skin. But mine is lovely too.
Yeah, mine too.
Lovely,
yeah.
Lovely.
I have a dark tone.
Bossy.
Bossy.
Of course. Yeah, of course.
I'm sassy. Well, but we're going back to lovely.
Yeah, I already did a prep. I already did a Russian manicure. So I will show you. You see the very shiny cuticle?
Wow.
Yeah, very clean cuticle.
Beautiful.
Yeah. So I did already put prep and wipe, and now I'm gonna put the bond, the primer over it. And look how pretty this also is. It's also in a blush look.
It's an air drying primer, I believe, huh?
Yeah, it's an air drying primer, and now I'm gonna put it on.
Everything in one line.
Yeah.
That's gorgeous. The beauty.
It makes it the perfect complement to your nail table.
Yeah, very nice.
It's important not to touch the cuticle, I believe, especially when you did the combi manicure.
Yeah, it's very important to not touch it because we have removed all the dead skin. So I'm just gonna go away from the cuticle and applying the primer.
And it makes it more easy because you did the manicure.
Mm-hmm.
You can apply everything more easy.
Sharper.
Than if there are, yeah.
More perfectly.
Yeah, more perfect, yeah.
You see that it really is air drying.
Yeah.
But can you also put it in the lamplight?
Well, you could put it in the twin light if you want. Some people would like to do that with wand.
Yeah.
It has no chemical reaction that I can think of, but you can do it.
Okay.
Especially you know then that the client doesn't touch her skin.
Yeah.
That's true.
Exactly.
So does the smoothness of the bond help with the application of the blushes?
Yeah, of course, it will apply very smoothly. So I have my color that I choose for her, Lovely.
Yeah, every bottle.
Pink
is just
bottle. And now I'm going to apply my first layer. It's going to be a really thin layer of the blush that I will cure.
And as you can see, the brush is, of course, also perfectly made because it really fits the curvature of the cuticle.
True.
Really makes a perfect application.
Little round
super
shape
easy
at the end.
So is this a very thin, 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 thin coat?
Yeah, this is a very thin coat, just for adhesion.
And you focus on getting the whole nail packed in, as it were.
Yeah, you need borders, so now we have one.
Her nail shape already is gorgeous.
Yeah, it is.
But also very difficult to apply
absolutely.
This product.
Absolutely. You don't want to work too thick.
Yeah, but it's because of the C curve. It has a deep C curve, and the deep C curve is beautiful,
but
also difficult because most products, when you apply them on top of the C curve, have a tendency to go into the sidewalls, but not blushes.
Nope.
So, Silvana, it cures for about a minute, I believe.
Yeah, because it is such a thin layer, I will do it for 30 a second, but now I'm after the 30 seconds, I will build it a little bit more, and then I will cure for 60 seconds.
Yeah, the light penetrates faster when the coat is, of course, very thin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And you could also wear it like this if you want to have a really semi-natural sheer look.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Because
and a little bit of strength.
And a little bit of strength, like perfect for men like this.
Yeah, true.
The next application.
So the next application, I will do another layer, a really thin layer, but I will not cure it.
And why do you do this?
So I call it my swimming layer, so that the building layer will float in it very good.
That makes the bead that we apply next float out a little bit more.
Yeah, true.
You can do it without, but I prefer with because it's much easier.
So, okay, don't cure.
No, don't cure. And now I'm going to take a little bit of a drop.
On the same brush?
On the same brush, I will show you.
So very nice that you can do everything from the bottle with one brush.
Yeah, it's super super
it's
easy.
Super easy.
A little bit
so
of a drop.
So it's on one side of the brush, a drop, a droppy. Yeah.
Just a little drop. And now I'm applying it.
Let's go from...
to the cuticle.
So, yeah, we see it perfectly. Yeah? Yeah, so you first focus on the cuticle and you lift it up straight upward to make sure that the product stays there. Huh? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
It's like massaging it.
I'm just massaging the gel.
And we can see the coat.
It's really soft and
gorgeous like this.
And this whole treatment
looks like a slow-mo video.
Yeah. Slow and...
yeah, but you also
relaxing.
See that the product stays.
It stays.
Because
you wear
the cuticle, it doesn't seep
run.
Out.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And already it very creates smooth. The perfect color for her skin tone.
Yep, perfect, beautiful. So you do it all in one gentle application.
Yeah, one gentle application.
I'm so curious how it looks from the side.
Yeah.
Yeah, here you can see.
Oh, like
it.
This. Beautiful.
Beautiful.
Wow.
Yeah, and you see that it really keeps its shape.
Yeah,
it's leveling perfectly.
So you want to do the non-filing technique, so then you want to perhaps detail it a little bit around the cuticle.
Yeah, I'm going to use my blush brush. And I'm just putting a little bit more around the cuticle.
And do you have some blush on your brush when you do it? Or is it a dry blush?
No, it is a wet brush.
Yeah.
And you can play a little bit with the coverage.
Yeah.
Because now it's semi-sheer.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But you could make it a little bit thicker if you wanted to make it more opaque.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Or
yeah.
thinner if you want to have it more sheer.
Yeah. But I think with Katri's C-curve, you cannot apply too much.
No. But you see that the curvature,
really
the arch, stays where she put it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
It doesn't
stays
run. She doesn't
place.
Need to turn the finger upside down or something.
No.
And it isn't too high either.
I love it.
No, she's really good.
I think we got the perfect shape.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And now I'm going to cure it for 60 seconds.
60 seconds is, of course, a must because the product now has to fully cure.
Yeah.
This is also suitable for the non-filing technique.
Yeah, of course, very suitable because it's so easy. Well, of course, you know, you have to know how it works, but if you know exactly what you do, you don't have to file anymore because I love filing, but I can do this without filing.
It's
so
true.
That says a lot.
Yeah, and how do you find the workability?
It's perfect. Yes. I really, really love it. And it's so, it has so much strength.
But do you find you can compare it to one of the other products that we have in our range?
Well, it's really a bit odd because it's really hard, but it's flexible too.
Yeah. Yeah.
So at first I said, no, acrylics, like hardness of the acrylics, but you can bend your nails. So
that's strange.
It's really
right.
strange.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah, and so and in application-wise, do you find you can compare it to a product?
No, not really. No, actually not.
No, building base is thinner.
And it doesn't run. So
yeah, that's true, but it's self-leveling.
Yeah,
that's perfect. You have the rubber base, but then you have to mold.
Yeah, but still, that's
because
different.
Otherwise it goes a little bit...
And a little
really
bit more lumpy
and easy
than this one. Like,
so the viscosity is just on par for that perfect... Yeah. Non-filing application. Yep. So 1.5 minutes, it always feels a long time when we're here in the studio.
It does.
But I guess we're about there. So let's go back to Silvana.
Yeah, it has cured fully. So now I'm removing the sticky layer with prep and wipe. And then I'm going to put the top gel over it.
Yeah, you so always we also remove the sticky layer, Silvana?
You can also not remove it, but I prefer to.
That's just a choice.
Yeah.
You like to work it because you have more control over your top gel by removing the sticky layer.
Yeah, and I will see what is applied with the top gel because the nail now has no shine.
Mm-hmm.
So I prefer to remove it.
Yeah, okay. Yeah,
otherwise, of course, you have shine on shine. Yeah. So that's difficult to see.
Yeah. It's smart.
And it has a little bit of a shine right now.
Can you leave it like this? Do you need to top coat it?
Well, we had a training this weekend by chance, and that question came along quite often. You can leave it like this, but you will notice that it gets a little bit shinier during the day.
Yeah.
Because the fats of the skin really saturate the upper layer.
Yes. Yeah.
So you can wear it like that, but if you really want to have that extreme matte finish, I would recommend... Guess what? Extreme matte.
I wore that lovely color for almost 2 weeks without a top because I wear it underneath my art.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But it was so beautiful that I was just like, oh. Oh,
and then
another day over and another day. So and it stays. Yeah.
But this is like a satin finish.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, but still, we have a special blushes top gel.
Yes, we have a special blush top gel. I'm going to finish the nail with the blush top gel, also with a wood cap.
Yeah, it's just a jewel for your table.
Oh,
right?
Yeah, it
so beautiful.
I have them, of course, as well.
Of course.
Standing next to each other.
Yeah,
this is a top gel with a high UV filter, and that cools down a little bit the color of blush that you use, huh, Silvana?
Yeah, so it creates a little bit cooler shade.
And a high shine.
A higher
shine. So beautiful.
With a UV filter.
Yeah.
But it helps, for instance, some of the dark browner colors, like Bossy.
Yeah.
If you use this top gel, you first think, oh, that's a little bit brown. But if you apply the top gel, it cools it down immediately.
Yeah,
it's like a super refrigerator. Bam! And it's cool. So that really helps. But the shine is also perfect.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Oh, beautiful.
It is. It's really great.
So I have to see the, oh, look
and
at this.
And also no sticky layer.
Ta-da!
Yeah, that is true.
Oh, I love this color.
So I'm going to cure it for 90 seconds, and then we see the end result.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah, the top gel has to cure for 90 seconds. It is also important to have the top gel cool down before applying cuticle oil or seduction cuticle cream or scrubbing your hands.
Yeah, true. That's really important.
Why is that?
Well, otherwise, the shine will be not as much as it would be.
Yeah.
It's still fragile.
Yeah, it is.
And so you have to give it a minute or two.
Yeah.
To cool it down.
Yeah.
To cool down and to let all the molecules close.
Yeah.
So that when you start massaging it, it is really
And that
beautiful.
Is the perfect time to make the next appointment with your client.
Yeah, that's true.
And then it's all good. And then you can go with your oil or scrub or what do you do?
Silvana, you combine this blush treatment especially with seduction products because you find that that the application of the seduction products moisturizing the skin and hands really helps. Can you tell us something about that?
Yeah, because you work on a natural nail, so it's important that you will oil the natural nail very good and very good take care of the natural nail. So all my clients need to buy the cuticle oil for at home.
So they have homework.
Yeah,
that's a must.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, and you also, I believe, still always use the scrub after the surface before you make the photos.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, always use scrub to make the perfect photos after because it will glow, it will shine and make the perfect end result. So I always use scrub and no cuticle oil.
Talking about that perfect end result, I'm so anxious how that nail looks.
Me too. Mm-hmm. Me too.
Wow.
Let's have a look. Pretty
look
color, lovely.
Beautiful.
You see how pretty it is on her skin tone.
Mm-hmm.
12 skin colors for the perfect match?
Of course.
And your clients will remember the name of the color that she wears.
Yeah, trust they me. Always know.
They
yeah.
do. Yeah,
because
they do.
You just want to go to your girlfriends and tell them, yeah, see,
I'm lovely. Lovely. Yeah,
exactly,
lovely.
That one.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Sil. It is really inspiring to see how easy this application is, but we have more different application variations, so feel free to join in when we also talk about those different ones and we do the voiceover. So if you see something that you want to add to, because I know you have experience with that, just add in, because the first one that we're going to go to now is our friend from the Ukraine,
Natalia.
Yeah. And Natalia loves blushes,
yeah,
but she glitters like a bomb. Ah. So here we see Bitchy, another one of those cool colors.
Yeah.
And we see here the nail for the slightly older client, the round shape.
Yeah, true.
And Natalia likes to work with a small brush for that first layer.
Yeah, and that's very smart because now she can really focus on the cuticle, not to touch it.
Yeah, and really rub it in.
Yeah, maybe a little bit.
And of course the...
Yeah, she works with that a lot.
Yeah.
It's really, really cool to see.
But it's also so easy. I work with it a lot as well.
Yeah,
me too.
Yeah, can't live without it.
A trend now is a glitter boom at a cuticle. And I know, Sylvana, you do that quite a lot as well.
Yeah, I do that a lot of times in my salon. It's so cute. It's so easy.
So follow us here in this application. She applies the chameleon flakes to the base layer of the blush.
Yeah.
Do you do the same?
Yeah, I do the same. Yeah, it's going to go underneath.
So we're going a little bit over the chameleon flakes now.
Yeah. Yeah.
So but can we see this later on?
Yeah, we can. Yeah, because it's so shiny.
So she put a drop in the semi-center of the nail, and we're going to go
And blend.
Yeah. Blend.
But don't use too much of the blushes over that.
No, it's really a small effect now.
It's a little bit. Yeah.
Yeah.
And the only blush with a glitter, Bitchy.
Yeah,
you can see the glitter right now.
Yeah.
A tiny shimmer.
This has
a tiny
shimmer,
yes. More like a shimmer.
So make sure that everything is nice and even.
Yeah.
And you see it also here, because these are quite deep sidewalls.
Yeah, true.
And it does not go in there.
No.
And again.
Flash curing again.
And that effect, I love it right now.
Yeah.
But she wants a little bit more.
More.
So this is a multi-dimensional glitter
room. So yeah, it's more depth like this.
Yeah.
My kind of girl.
And of course, the base layer is also there to protect the natural nail if you want to do a fill, because then you don't go too deep.
Yeah, it's the best thing to do. Again, the flesh cure is so easy.
And the flakes are perfect for natural nails because they are so thin.
Yeah.
And it's also not too much in your face.
No.
It's like soft.
Yeah, very soft.
You can, of course, choose to also work with our other top gels in the magnetic range, because everything is compatible.
Mm-hmm.
So you can use Extreme Matte, you can use Supreme Finish, you can any of the diamond dusts.
Mix and match.
Yeah, mix and match, flex and shine, everything is possible. So just clean around the cuticle with that unparalleled rosewood stick.
Oh, wow. Look at that.
This. It's really natural.
Yeah.
And you see that the free edge, of course, Deborah has some socials for us.
Oh, wow.
Yes, I do, Pepijn. And the first one is of myself. And this one I called, It Isn't So Bad to Get Spoiled. So this is my spoiled set, and I really, really, really love this
color.
They're
beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Very nice. Really beautiful. Very nice picture as well.
Yeah, I love the picture.
Yeah. I thought you can see, a thumb is quite a big nail, but still with this product, even on a short nail, it still isn't thick or big nail. So I really love it like this. And my next one is of Victoria Schramm from Italy. And what I love about this picture is you can see the nail before, then after the manicure, and then the complete nails. I really like this set. And this is the Cozy, and this color is very nice on round nails also. So these are my socials for this week. And next, we have a beautiful commercial You saw the first one that was without the application, but now you're going to see the commercial with the application of the blushes. Enjoy.
That commercial, oh, so and it's much. Really for every one of us.
Yeah, yes. You can
for
see
all
it
of us.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
Sil, do you ever choose, instead of using chameleon flakes for your glitter cuticle boom, to use, for instance, the glitter gel polish?
Yeah, I also use glitter gel polish because it's very thin, what I say, with chameleon flakes. Also, gel polish is very thin, so you get not like a really thick natural nail.
Okay, cool. Yeah, I think that really works.
Yeah.
And I believe we even have a trainer that prepared something for us with that glitter gel polish. And who is this? This is, of course, our other friend.
Yeah. Yeah. Little Katarina.
Yeah, our little Katya. Katya is also from the Ukraine.
Yeah, yeah, she is.
Doing a lot of air nails classes.
Yeah.
Has a very beautiful nail salon as well.
Yeah, she does.
And she used a lot of blushes in the last months to create beautiful photos and to play around a little bit with the techniques.
Yeah, but she can do everything. So
yeah.
she can. Yeah. Well, now blushes, and there's Katarina.
Our multi-talented Katarina Conchard. So Katarina is also working on the natural nail, and she's had prepared the natural nail.
Yeah.
In the Ukraine, doing the Russian manicure is quite a normal thing.
Yeah, they're familiar with that. Yeah.
Yeah. And she also likes to work with a normal gel brush.
Yeah, I think it's very smart. Very, very smart to use that.
Yeah, it's not necessary as Silvana showed us,
but
you have a little bit more control.
Yeah, true. Mm-hmm. And not too much product.
Maybe if you're not used to working with the product, you start using first the gel brush.
Here are some glitters.
Yeah.
Which glitters are these? But which ones?
I think it's
Balmasqué.
The Balmasqué
glitters. Pulcinella.
Beautiful line.
Yeah, and you're very thin.
Glitter.
And do you remember that the Balmasqué glitters are very flat?
Yeah, that's
nice.
Yeah.
It's easy to really.
Yeah, and to work around the cuticle as well, because that's beautiful.
I use them also a lot.
Yeah. Okay.
Very easy. Although this is a heavy combination.
Yeah, but beautiful end result.
Is this the dreamy? The very white
dreamy or cozy?
I think
one
cozy
of those
or cozy.
Cozy. A little bit warmer than the white dream.
Yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So she's now staying away from the very end of the cuticle.
Yeah. She's going to blend it in later.
And you can see she's patting the nail, but even then it's still
smooths
out.
You can see that it's already smoother.
So easy to work with.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
And this is really hot at the moment, Silvana.
Yeah, and I love the combination of gold glitters with a peachy, cozy color.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Wow.
But not on 10 nails, I think.
Well, I will wear it, but on one nail, it's also possible.
And again,
a little bit extra.
But this also is a good Christmas combination.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And she now uses a detailer 3.
Yeah.
So another brush.
So if that is all cured, then she applies the top gel to bind it all together.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, beautiful.
Cool nail.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. I love it all.
Very posh.
Gorgeous.
Yeah.
Very elegant.
And the 3D effect of this glitter.
Oh my.
Nice, huh?
I'm in love.
So pretty.
Beautiful.
Oh, it's cozy.
That's a good combination.
Yeah, it is.
Sometimes the names and the colors are, perhaps you don't remember, as I do, always all the names and colors. That's why we developed this great color chart to use in the salon, or to just show your clients, or to take with you when you visit one of our distributors and tell them, well, I already have bitchy, but now it's time to get bossy.
Yeah.
So ask our distributors for this color chart, and they will supply it to you. You can see everything. The trend with these short nails is minimalistic, huh?
Yeah,
a little bit of glitter at the cuticle.
Yeah.
So we have another trend that we're going to show, and that is just a little bit of
gold.
Foil.
A little bit of gold foil.
Yeah. And matte.
Here and there. Matte. And this is done by Natalia. Another natural nail,
yep.
A little bit damaged, yep. Natural nail. Mm-hmm. So here comes the coverage in play, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fierce.
Oh, wow.
Love that name as well.
I love all the names.
Yeah.
This is slightly more beige.
Caramel vibe, yeah. You could also use Sealant Protect underneath it.
Yeah.
Yeah, to strengthen the natural nail from within.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's a smart addition, thank you. Yeah, if you have damaged nails, use Steel and Protect just to reinforce your natural nails from within.
Already a little bit of coverage right now with that first layer.
Yeah.
And Natalia really likes to do the curvature of the nail with her brush from the bottle.
Yeah.
And don't forget it, these are builders in a bottle, so they protect your nails like a builder gel would. Although we also have some other builder gels in bottles, but these are specifically designed for that.
And she's picking up some extra gel to fill up the gaps.
Yeah, to smooth it out.
Yeah, and to smooth it out as well.
But you see already by the light reflection that the nail has its curvature
where it has to be.
Look.
Yeah.
Wow. It does the work for you.
And it really matches the skin tone of her model as well, eh?
Yeah, and bye-bye spots.
Yeah, because a trend is that you either match your skin tone perfectly or you find a contrast color.
Yeah, or you go like the other way.
Like super white on the dark skin.
Yeah, like me.
Like you are having at the moment. Oh, a second coat.
Yes, because it was not completely smooth out.
So just a layer.
Yeah, a layer. She works in layers right now.
Yeah, you have very full coverage right now. Yeah.
So you can take a lot and then make your apex.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Or use layers like Natalia is doing right now.
Now this is also easy.
Yeah, it's also easy. You see now it's even more perfect than the second layer.
And now it's really bye-bye spots.
Yeah.
Yeah, now it's all hidden.
Yeah. And you still see some of the color of the free edge.
Right.
Which I like.
Yeah.
I love it. Because this gives a sense of translucency.
Yeah, exactly.
The natural look.
Yeah.
She really adores to work with flesh care.
Yeah, she does.
So on the sticky layer of that blush, some gold foil.
That's great.
You could also use the 24 karat gold foil.
Yeah.
I do that a lot.
Love that.
But I love this look also.
And even in mattes.
Because you can see the holographic a bit.
Yeah.
See through.
Yeah.
And it sticks to the surface of the blush, so the cured surface of the blush. Well, that's good to know. A little bit like fiber coat.
Yeah.
That sticks really good, huh?
And this is so special. Now we see the extreme matte coming out of the nail.
That's bizarre.
Very great.
Wow.
Super fat cool.
Super
fat
cool.
Yeah, that's how we say it in Holland.
That's the way you feel it right now.
Also, the balance between shine and matte.
Yeah.
And a good color combination.
Beautiful.
Perfect.
Great set.
Perfect. Wow. Yeah.
Beautiful shape as well.
Yeah. Also,
very sharp.
Wow.
Show off.
Yeah. But she had the chance to work with the product, of course, a couple of months already, because we send it to her and Katharina. And just amazing output. The two of you are just making beautiful nails,
as is
everybody else. Do you think our little queen of nail art, with the high hair, that blushes are also suitable for stamping?
You think?
Well,
you think?
I ask. What do you think?
I think that would be red, Pepijn. Yeah.
Oh.
Really fast nail art. Do you think we have a demo of that?
Well, I think Katja and you are like on the same level.
Yeah, so maybe not real same height, but
almost the same height.
But Katharina Conchard made a combination
of
blushes and stamping.
Really cool.
another natural nail and another beautiful natural nail as well.
Yeah, it's perfect.
Yeah, it's a nice perfect nail natural bed. Nail.
The length of the nail bed, wow.
Yeah, wow.
Yeah, but also the nice flat-ish kind hypernickia.
Yeah, yeah, that too. Yeah.
So, again, first layer with a brush,
yeah.
gel brush. And now she's just continuing to really press in that first adhesion layer.
Yeah,
do you also like to do that, Silvana? Or is that more an advanced technique that you develop for your advanced blush classes?
Yeah, with a brush, I do that more with the in the advanced classes, yeah.
But would you leave the first layer without curing in this way?
No, still no. you need still to cure in between. Because that anchors the product to the natural nail surface. And if you apply, otherwise this layer would be fully wet, and then the light would not penetrate.
Okay.
This is, again, one of the blushes, of course. Sil, do you do a lot of, did you already try to do stamping on the blushes?
No, I did not, but I would love to do. I'm going to do it tomorrow. Yeah, I'm going to do it tomorrow.
I think you
she
did.
Said, she said no, but she make a set of blush nails with a stamp.
Yeah, I saw a snake.
Oh, but not with a new stamping plate.
No.
Yeah, because we made special blushes stamping plates. Yeah.
They are amazing.
And then you can stamp the name of your blush on your nail.
Yeah. That's so super fat cool.
Okay, Silvana, a quiz. What and color do you think this is?
Oh, I think girly.
I think so too.
Yeah, I think girly because it has a little bit of a lilac kind of shine.
Yeah, very cool.
And that actually gets enhanced even more when you use the top gel. Huh? Yeah, then the lilac really becomes lilac.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, oh, the white stamp. Oh, she's living the dangerous
Ta-da!
Life.
Wow.
This is already perfect. Love this.
Yeah, but I'm so used from that she uses the transparent stamp.
Yeah,
that I find this really living on the edge.
Yeah,
living on the edge.
I can't see by your stamp, but she does it more often.
Then
you can
combination
see.
With
that is tribals. Wow.
Well, no, I feel a wedding vibe here, not a tribal vibe.
Okay, I saw tribal on the Frenchies.
Yeah,
a tribal
definitely girly.
That is amazing. Really, really cool. And I saw a tribal too, Deborah. But I went on the socials for you too and found some blushes. The first one is mine. I really love that picture. But a little bit of art, because I love art, you know me.
Did you do that hand painting?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, cool.
I did do that hand painting. But as we mentioned before, we have a stamping plate coming out soon. And then you don't have to hand paint. This one is Linda. And Linda used the color Spoiled, I believe. But look at that. I really love it. It's really thin. Yeah, perfect.
Yeah, real natural perfection.
Yeah, yeah, really love it. So, and the last, this is Cerise. And she had a story by telling that her clients always wore long nails. And she wanted short nails now. Really natural short nails with a little bit of art. So I really, really love it. I love them both, but and a beautiful
thank
picture
you.
Too. Yeah, so thank you. So we have one last demo for you waiting, and that is Natalia again. And Natalia is showing us easy nail art. The thin French, this is really an upcoming trend right now. You see it a lot, and you see how Natalia is doing it. So let's go have a look.
We see Natalia, the natural nail, and of course she's also going to use Bond on this natural nail because Bond is an absolute must, Silvana.
Yeah, yeah, for adhesion. But if I see this a natural nail, I prefer to put Seal Protect underneath it.
I agree.
Yeah, I understand what you mean.
Yeah,
me too.
Again, with a little brush. I believe this is actually one of the one-stroke detailers.
Yeah.
I think she's using Fierce again.
Yeah, but with a name like Fierce, of course you use it again.
So that's first layer, our second layer.
You already mentioned the fact that this is minimalistic art.
Mm-hmm.
In my time and place, French was not minimalistic art. It was just the basic.
Yeah.
Yeah. Absolutely, yeah, true. True. But this is really thin. So it's really a thin, line.
You better thin. So a super thin line. And this is also something that you showed me quite a lot, Silvana, because it's we don't want to have the real round, deep smile lines.
No.
It's really almost a flat line.
Yeah, it's almost a flat line and really thin. So you get a really long nail bed.
Yeah.
I think it's a little bit more easy to apply than the classic way.
Except when you are like me, because I just jump into the automatic pilot and just go
yeah, me too.
Like
yeah,
a deep oval smile line, and then Silvana comes in. She looks at my nails and she says, "Well, you can really see your age."
Oh my god!
Young people like the, as we see here.
Yeah, this one
with the thin liner brush. Here we make the corners a little bit more.
Yeah.
A little bit more in the corners.
Yeah.
To round it off a little bit. Silvana, you take it a little bit higher in the corners.
Yeah, I will put it a little bit higher.
Okay.
Maybe it's me, but I don't really understand it.
Yeah, but you can play around with it. It's a little piece of art, so you can decide what you like.
Yeah.
I mean, I like a
trendy
deep
right now.
Me too.
Deep smile line.
Yeah, me too. But this is also nail art. You can see it like nail art.
Yeah.
And make you play around with it.
And you can use a mixture of Cerise Sweeties and liner gel white or liner gel white or even extreme white.
Yeah, you can. Oh, as well.
For the more extreme look.
Yeah. Or you can use gel polish for a colored thin French.
Yeah,
oh,
of course.
Yes, because that's also very modern.
Yeah.
The strange neon lines.
Yeah. Or the liner gel with pigments.
Oh, that you think it's strange.
I want to say like that. You can also make some pigments on these nails. Yeah.
So play around with it.
I love these pigments.
I love it. Ta-da!
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the really modern version
it
of
is.
French manicure.
Yeah.
It's nice.
Nice
like
that.
Picture.
Yeah.
So that was a full show.
It is.
Yeah.
Wow.
We had a lot.
We had a lot. We covered a lot. You saw a lot of different ways how to apply the blushes and how to create the blush trend. Hip and happening also in your salons.
Yeah.
Before we end, of course, I want to thank you, Silvana, not only for being here tonight, but for helping us develop all of these blushes and to give all of your artistic input to us.
Well, thank you. It was an adventure. And thank you all for watching. I'm so excited to see all your pretty blush designs.
Yeah, and of course, Silvana will come back in our show in demos, in the Dutch show. She's always, of course, there.
Yeah, that's
so
true.
Better think, Silvana. Mm-hmm. So what is our theme next week, girls? We're going to go to nail art.
Landscape.
Landscape.
On nails.
Uh-huh. Yeah. Landscapes.
Pieces of art on nail.
Yeah.
So we go the complete opposite direction.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's true.
From very soft and feminine and sedate.
And no more minimalistic.
Like bold and full.
Yeah. We're going to go all the way Bob Ross style to the nail art department.
Very interesting. Awesome.
Very interesting. Because everything you do on or with nails is the most interesting thing we live for.
Yeah, well, that's true.
Absolutely true.
So, see you next week.
Yeah.
See you at
Nails Talk Live.
Bye-bye. Bye.